the seal has to come out. Every time you pack the bearings, you have to destroy a seal and put a new one in. It's just the way it works. There's actually two different ways of doing it. One way is, I know they have a special tool for it, but I don't have it. Most people don't. But what I like to do, I like to take a punch and then just push this in a little bit, or actually make a hole in it, so it pulls this, the seal, away from the edge, where you can take a screwdriver in there, tap it in a few times, then pop it out. It's a little bit less stressful on the bearing. The other way of doing it, if you don't have that, you can take a wooden stake or something, or you know, like a handle of this, then you just go through there and beat it out that way. It puts a lot of wear and tear on the bearing, but it's another way of doing it. See there or not, but how I punched it in and it brought the seal away from the edge. And that's what we'll try to work in our screwdriver. There we go. We'll go ahead and get the bearing out, wipe it down real fast. And a little bit easier to see. Rotate the bearing cage, look for anything that bounces up and down too much. This is a straight, almost, you know, a continuous line, so. I think the cage is pretty good on this one, so I just keep cleaning it up until it spins freely. Because I'm looking for little nicks, stuff like that. Sometimes you can see a little bit of wear, like it's like a dark band here and a light band here and a dark band here. For the most part, that's kind of acceptable. It's not perfect, but in this case, I think it'll be fine. If it's really dark, then definitely you want to change that, because that part of the bearing, this actual roller, got overheated. But this one looks pretty darn good. We got to take out the braces. So what we got to do is catch from the back edge of this and force it out. A couple different ways of doing it. Most people just use a nice wide screwdriver, catch the edge of it, and just wail away. Just go alternating sides and just work it out both sides. Another way of doing it is if you got a piece of pipe like this where it catches, see, it's not, but most of a bigger chunk of a circle, that way you have more force going down on it to push down one side or the other. I like to start it off with a screwdriver and then finish up with that. More times. There's the old brace. Don't throw this away because we'll need this to push the new one back in with. We'll set that to the side. We'll drive the inner brace out the back side. One end is wider than the other. Put the narrow end, or I guess the cone facing out that way, like the cone in this way. Just go ahead and just lay it on there and just tap in the circle. You hear it change the tone, it means bottomed out. So take your other raise, your old one, put it on top, and drive it down just a little bit more of that. Don't go too far because you might get this one stuck in there too. Find the biggest socket you have so you can put it up against the edge where you can grab most of this edge right here with the socket, and you can just go back and forth and work it. Just kind of maybe go in a circle, work your way down. Know when you hit bottom when the strikes make a different tones. Do the same thing for the back side. pack this side, we'll flip it over, then pack the other side. Be a good guy, put your light coating on the race itself. Actually, it doesn't take much. You don't have to pack it full. There's a lot that doesn't get really used. In a marine application like this, you want to go ahead and get the grease gun out, and you, since it has the special spindles, go ahead and fill the cavity that way. But for most land trailers, this is pretty much enough as it is. Grab your new bearing here. Just what you gotta do is work it inside of here. Just put it a little bit at a time. Keep going around. Flip it over. And you want to get it inside of here. Just get inside so when the bearing starts spinning, it gets all worked up in there. Spins maybe before you pop it in there. Pop in a new seal, and it just goes in the rubber side facing up. You notice this is a double lip seal, which is really good for marine applications. You can tell if it's a double lip seal if it has a spring in there. So there's this one lip here, and there's one on the outside. It's a lot more durable seal. Pop that on there like so. Go in a circle again. There you go. Don't get crazy, it just has to be flush right here. Don't bang it down in there or anything like that. So flip it and do it again.